On court two, please welcome Superman Jomkoh and Superman Paewsampran, Thailand.
So here they come. Second seeds have been in great form.
Ready to play. Ladies and gentlemen, on our right, Yuta Watanabe and Higashino, Japan. And on my left, Supak Jomkoh and Supisara Paewsampran, Thailand. Supak Jomkoh to serve, to Arisa Higashino. Love all. Play. Service zone, one love. Service over, 1-3.
Indonesia, and the service girls, Andi Purnama, Indonesia.
Four,
ladies
three.
And gentlemen, please welcome Richard Yu, Hong Kong, China.
Service over, 4-9.
Thank you.
shuttle is already not in play. Your shuttle is still is already not in play, so it's okay. No, it's his point. That point. No, your shuttle's already not in play. Touch the net. Your shuttle touched the net and fall. Second touch. You mean double touch? No. Was it double touch? No, there's no double touch. Sorry, we didn't see that. Yeah. Service over, 10-4. Play. Service over. Yes. 12-7. Service over. 8-12.
Watanabe and Higashino looking a little bit shell-shocked from this very aggressive start.
15-8.
The points aren't stopping there either.
Service over, 9-15. Service over, 16-9.
They've really jumped on them.
Service over, 10-16.
Back too high. Very, very quickly looking like they are going to be bagging this first game in some style. Get it. Jomkoh with the mistake. And a chance now for the second seeds. They took control of that point, just like they've been taking care of most of his points in this first game. Badminton from the tie pair, and we've got themselves 8 game points. Only needed 1. 21-12. Great start from the tie pair. Thank you.
on Watanabe and Higashino.
Okay. Second game. Watanabe is making all the difference here in the second game. And the engine behind this revival. Great touch from Higashino, moving forward as well. Just couldn't make the killer at the end. But great work from her during that point. Three, six. Return from Watanabe. He was off and moving while that shuffle had just left the service racket. Higashino still finding a couple of range problems at net.
4-7. Service over, 8-4.
It's really well done again by Watanabe. His main priority right now is just keep that shuttle flat across the net. Give nothing for his opponents to really feed off. Great court coverage. Moves across from right to left. Finds his angle right down the middle. So not quite there yet. Closing in on the mid-game interval for the second game.
5-10.
Six, Oh, that's gone too long. Higashino looks to the sky. Well, they're definitely looking, Watanabe and Higashino, for a good run here at the Indonesia Open after being beaten in spectacular fashion by Christensen and Boyer in Singapore. Their first title of the year. So close for Supersara, but no joy.
Court 2, 20 seconds. Players back on court.
So on for the second part of game two.
11.
And this
six.
Is turning into
play.
Quite a match to kick off this action on court two today.
Yes. 12-6.
Jomkoh and Paewsampran now feeling a bit more pressure from some great front court play, especially. But it's that man, Watanabe, that's really sparked into life. Late take by Watanabe, bronze medalist at the Olympic Games in 2020, of course.
12.
But also remembered for those two silver medals at the World Championships last couple of years. He'll be searching for the gold later on this year. Add to their collection. But saying that, with all those accolades, they are really being pushed to the limit here by Jomkoh and Paewsampran.
8-12.
Higashino will take out
that
of the
over
camera deck.
13-8.
Rescue shuffle there. 13-8. Oh, these are very important points for the Japanese pair. And they've started
15-8.
With a good one. If they can get themselves up to 17 or 18, then they can push this to a third game.
Service over. 9-15.
Service back with Jomkoh and Paewsampran. That was a little bit high, but still
10,
didn't matter.
15.
Higashino couldn't get on top of that. wonderful from Paewsampran, not necessarily hitting Watanabe, but her movement. She had to really check her run. Just look at the way she moves forward here. The reach over at the end. Well, the best thing to do is go for the body shot. Actually knocked Watanabe to the ground, but once again, great movement. Then you've got a feeling that they might just be able to push this.
11,
drift conditions 15. Here so far, looking, they're blowing up your screen. So,
play.
But really in an arena like this, sometimes it changes. That's brilliant from Jomkoh. And that's really good from Higashino.
Service over, 16-11.
16-11. Well, of all the four players, even with a high level of quality,
16.
Higashino has been the biggest culprit, I think, especially in that net area, just front court to, well, our right, her left. Hasn't really been connecting there. It's another chance for Jomkoh. Paewsampran. That was great from Yuto Watanabe. Played both sides of Jomkoh. First made him stretch to the left, and then killed it to the right. 17-12. This time though.
18-12.
Now closing in on the second game. Crouch defense from Higashino, snatching at it. Watanabe comes in to settle the ship. Oh. We're seeing some really developed rallies from both pairs now, and it's good value.
Fault receiver, foot 20, game point 12.
So this one will be going to three by the looks of it.
Not quite yet. 13-20.
That sounded like Higashino actually may have dropped the string there, but
won by Yuta
string or no string, job done.
21-13. One game off.
This one going to a third.
Thank you.
2, 20 seconds. Ball 2, 20 seconds.
So back on court for game 3.
Final game, level play.
While the difference in terms of achievements between both of these pairs is quite startling, Jomkoh and Paewsampran still looking for that first title. Higashino and Watanabe, 9 titles on the World Tour, including the Indonesia Open runner-up last year. They were beaten by none other than Detchapol and Sapsiri.
Thank you.
So many talented pairs in the mixed doubles arena.
So
far, all of them still in the mix, except of course for Go Sun Huat and Siobhan Lai, the only seeded pair that's out in the first round.
2-1.
Straight on the attack for Paewsampran. Forced into a clear. Wow, Watanabe possibly went for one shot too many there.
7-0.
It's a difficult thing to say when you think about the coverage of court, but this was great. This was great. Wow, that was the one, that was the third shot. It didn't work out. 2-0.
Play.
Service error.
Service over.
An easy point.
3-2.
They can't allow themselves to dwell on that. Nerves getting to both pairs just for these last couple of points. That's a reflex return from Watanabe that has gone wide.
4-5.
Good movement by Paewsampran again. They may have caught Higashino and Watanabe out. Just couldn't put the killing blow in, Jomkoh.
Service over.
Well, they haven't just been pressuring with their shots, the Thai pair. It's also their movement forward, just cutting off areas of the court. getting a little bit too excited, I think.
Four. 7.
A low defense, and now they're on the attack, and Paewsampran again, the defining factor at the net. We have to pick between the two female players. I'd actually have to say it's pretty equally balanced right now, but the real difference is that Supisara Paewsampran has made a lot less errors and a lot more confident at the net. From Watanabe.
6-7.
Remember, that's definitely one of the windier parts of the court. You should have known better there. Higashino again, as I said, just a couple of key errors. Now she's switched sides. It's that same area of the net. It's giving her trouble, has been giving her trouble for the entire match.
Arisa, ready? Receive. Play.
Jomkoh had a double take on that. Next shot of his. Just there, and he's left couple watching. Lucky from Jomkoh. Higashino moving well from left to right this time. Just here, hijacks that shuttle, and it's to the body or close enough to win the point. 10-7. Watanabe just drifting. Skies drop shot in, and it's 11-7 in the third mid-game interval.
Court two, 20 seconds. Players back on court.
Careful play by Watanabe and Higashino, and that little backhand nick, good enough.
Seven.
Tight play from Japanese pair. again. Very tight play. Higashino just putting the punctuation mark on some good work from Watanabe at the back. In the difference.
14-7.
Whenever they've needed that little perk, he's popped up with some great shots from backcourt, midcourt. Jomkoh and Paewsampran with the fear that this third game might be running away from them. Fighting hard, Jomkoh and Paewsampran. But it's Higashino that sends in the missile just below the waist. Too low. So 16-7. Difficult shot to take. Just hanging in the air.
Thank you.
Well, they possibly were just a pair that started a bit slow after all their exertions in Singapore, I'm sure, but now back on track by the looks of it. Clash of rackets in the middle of it, they still managed
18,
to just
seven.
Pull in their range. That's the main thing. One of those shots looking like they were going to go wide. It's an 11-point lead, and they need just three. For Jomkoh, and I think he fears the worst. Another mistake from Jomkoh, relatively simple one, and he looks a little bit phased now. So 13 match points. The number two seeds. Dangerous times for the Thai pair. Higashino at the moment. 18-4. And they've done it. It's another mistake from Paewsampran, but in honesty, it was more of a desperation attempt in those last 5 or 6 points for Jomkoh and Paewsampran. They will have to fight another day and another tournament, as it's Watanabe and Higashino that come through the scare that first game
match
and finish
won by
in some style for their fans.
And Higashino. 12-21.
And Higashino all smiles now. They steamroll on. 12-21, 21-13, 21-7. And it's Watanabe and Higashino move on to round two.
At the Indonesia Open, and after a big win for Watanabe Higashino in this electric cauldron atmosphere, it's the women's singles. Bei Wen Zhang from the US taking on Kirsty Gilmore from Scotland.